Back with you live on American Idol. Last night it was the guys performing. Tonight we've got the girls fighting it out for your votes. And still to come, we've got some Coldplay. We've got a Kelly Clarkson song. What else is coming up that you guys have?
Aretha.
We have Aretha. So a lot of great music coming your way if you stay tuned. All right, Lacey, how has the shift in performance schedule this week affected you, good or bad?
I think it was okay for me because it just gave the girls a little bit more time to kind of sink into which song they were doing and get comfortable. I felt bad for the boys, really, because they didn't have a lot of time. So my focus was really like, oh, sorry, guys.
All right, why don't you get set to sing your song while we take a look at this. Here's something more about Lacey. Go ahead. Good luck.
Something that most people probably don't know about me yet is that I really like to go antique shopping for old furniture and kind of just refurbish it. I really like doing it just, first of all, just for myself. It's kind of relaxing for me. Out of all the pieces that I've done, I don't really keep any of them around in my house because by the time I get it painted, somebody sees it and wants it, and so I usually sell it or give it away. Right before I sing, I'm on stage. The mic's in front of me, the crowd's there. I tell myself, you are made to do this. It's something that my mom tells me. So I kind of just remind myself, hey, you are made to do this, so do it.
Took my love and I took it down.
Last week I sang Landslide. I really think that nerves played a bigger role.
After about 15 seconds, I was working out how much longer we've got to listen to this for.
America, I'm very sorry if I bored you.
I think something like Sixpence, None the Richer, Kiss Me, that's your vibe.
The funny thing about that is I already love that song and already wanted to do it live on the show for America to see. And so I just thought, well, all right, we'll just do that this week. I'm going to have a lot of fun with it, and I hope America likes it too.
Let's find out. Here she is, Lacey Brown.
Kiss me, out by the bearded barley nightly, beside the green, green grass. Swing, 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 swing your spinning step. You wear those shoes and I will wear that dress.
Kara, interesting choice.
Thanks, Randy.
No, listen. It's just funny how you picked that up off the screen. I was like, oh, hey, that's kind of cool. Listen, you know, I actually think it was a good song choice and it actually would have worked. But I felt like for most of the song, except for maybe one or two moments, I was looking for the words to flash across the screen like I'm just at a club or somewhere and we're doing karaoke. It just, there was nothing, you didn't bring anything to it. You didn't do anything with it. It was, you didn't do anything special with it.
Well, no, I don't think you did, you didn't change it up or anything, but I thought it was adorable. I thought you were great, and I thought that, I, I thought you sounded like it was the right song. I think last week we were saying that it was kind of a downer song, and you're just such an up person, and so it was a good choice. I thought that it was a good suggestion, and I thought it was adorable. I like your personality, and I like you.
Thank you. I like you too.
Last week, I felt like we were losing what was special about you, which is your tone. You have this very unique sound in your voice and vocal stylings, and this song, especially at the beginning, brought that back to the audience.
Good.
Which I liked. But I have to say that you have to step it up from here. Okay. Still.
Yeah.
You did do some things with the song, but you didn't push it to where it could have gone. But we're back in the playing field with you, because now we're listening to Lacey again.
Awesome.
We can hear your tone, and it's a happy song, because you're a happy girl. No landslide, depressing song. It's not for you. This is you, happy, smiley people. Lacey. Yes.
Thank you.
I think it's a step in the right direction for her, yes.
Yeah, look, I think it was marginally better than last week. I get the feeling with you, though, that you are taking part in a competition rather than showcase who you are as an artist. So whatever is suggested for you, you'll probably do, and do quite well. But you compare that to the first performance tonight from Crystal, there is a massive, massive difference here. One is showing America, I'm an artist. You come on, bounce around the stage, sing quite a nice, happy little song, and we're not going to remember it. And that's the problem.
All right, Lacey. So, picking up on his point there, Simon's point, you think you could have done something differently to make it more memorable?
I don't know what he was saying about you just do whatever.
I just
didn't understand the whole you do whatever we tell you to do. I actually wanted to do this song before she suggested it. It was a great suggestion.
You should never do something you don't want to do on
the
stage.
I love that song. And so, I don't know, just that.
So
that
was
just a little. Huh?
We're all happy.
And yeah, I'm happy.
Good. And shiny, feeling good.
We're all happy. All
right. Yeah. If you want to vote for Lacey, it's 1-866-IDOL-03, 1-866-436-5703, or you can text the word vote to 5703. Lines open at the end of the show. Thank you, Lacey. Good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We're going to leave you for just a moment. Katie Stevens, live next.